Do you enjoy World War II? What about classic Call of Duty? What about Battlefield? If you say yes to one or any of those things, then I think you're really going to like the game that we're going to be discussing today. Now, remember, before we start the video, to leave a nice, thick, and juicy like, as always. And of course, if you want more content like this, then hit that big, red, sexy subscribe button right underneath the video. Also, gotta shout out my channel members. You guys help make these videos possible. Thank you so very much. If you wanna join and get access to the exclusive perks that they get, then check out the link in the description or hit the blue join button. Anyway, let's begin. From the creators of War Thunder, Gaijin Entertainment, comes a free-to-play FPS, combined arms FPS, that is, called Enlisted. Enlisted is an extremely fun game, and it would be very underselling it to simply call it a blend between Call of Duty, Battlefield, and War Thunder, because I think it's something that is definitely different and a fresh take on things that offers a lot more than some of the more traditional FPS World War II experiences do. Let's start off with the gameplay. Gameplay-wise, it's kind of what you would expect from this type of game. It's not a hardcore, overly precise type of competitive style game with this extremely smooth movement and whatnot. There's definitely an element of realism to it, so it's a little bit slower than you would find in a game like a Call of Duty or even like a Battlefield. It doesn't feel all that ultra smooth to move around, and some of the animations look a little off. But that's okay, because the gameplay in general is phenomenal. The thing with this game that separates it from all the others is the game mode squads. Now, there are two different main game modes that you are going to uncover within squads. There is a more linear, almost breakthrough style mode that you would find in Battlefield, where you have to go in and you have to capture objectives within a row to get to the final one. And then there's one that's more of like conquest, where you have different objectives around a map and you have to go and capture those. And then whoever runs out of tickets first loses. Now, squads is called squads for a reason. You're in a squad, but not like Battlefield. You're essentially the leader of an AI squad, and these AI squad members are going to follow you around, and you have some orders, not really. They're not the brightest bunch in the world, and there's not a lot you can do with them, but they do come into play in the fact that if your player-controlled character dies, you can switch over to one of them. You can actually also get revived by them if you get hit and knocked down. So there are some benefits to the squad members, and it's a really nice aspect of the game, because comparing squads to the lone wolf mode, which is where you play as an individual soldier and there are no AI squad mates, it feels much more like two large armies clashing in an area of the war, rather than your run-of-the-mill generic FPS with hardcore elements and things like that. I enjoy the squads mode a lot more. Now, granted, don't get your hopes up when you drop 60 kills and only die like four times, because the majority of the people that you're going to kill are AI opponents. So, you know, you're not joining FaZe Clan after a round of this game where you just absolutely kill it, because most likely you killed a bunch of AI opponents rather than humans. Now, that doesn't mean that it's not fun to go around and just wreck entire servers. It is very fun to do that kind of a thing, and it feels like an almost power trip when you do that, even though it is AI opponents. I would compare it a little bit to that mode they added, I think it's called Galactic Supremacy in Star Wars Battlefront 2, where you do have some of the AI opponents who aid the player opponents within the game, and it adds a kind of nice aspect to it. They can be of help and they can be of use, but they're mostly available for, like I said, when you die and you need a revive, or you can switch over to one of them and take advantage of whatever weapons that they have. It's a very fun mode. I really enjoy it. It adds a lot to the combined arms aspect of the game. Speaking of combined arms, you can jump into tanks and you can jump into planes. You do have to unlock the planes. I haven't gotten to the point to where I've been able to fly a plane, but I have used a tank. It's pretty difficult to use, but they're extremely powerful, and I like that aspect of it. They're also pretty able to be taken out. If you have the right equipment and the right squad mates who are equipped with the right things, you can take out tanks somewhat easily. I found, you know, just grab your dynamite and chuck it at them and you're gonna have yourself quite a day. But at the same time, they can take out a lot of enemies fairly easily if they're positioned correctly. It's balanced pretty well. I never found myself just overly annoyed by tanks consistently taking me out or just sitting in the back of a map. The maps are small enough that they're always going to be in the action in a way, and I really, really enjoyed that aspect of it. It felt like there was constantly something going on. I would describe it as setup and positioning feels like that of a hardcore game. But once the action starts, be it whatever you're using, whatever squad, whatever vehicle you're using, it feels like the most high-octane action in any FPS that you're going to be able to experience. And again, that comes from the fact that you have so many extra players firing guns at each other in this game. You have so many vehicles and whatnot. It's an extremely fun game. It also has a decent level of destruction on the maps. Of course, you can open doors and windows, but you can also destroy some walls and stuff. There's some really cool stuff like that. I don't think you're ever going to sit and play it and think, oh, this is like Battlefield where I can take out entire buildings, because it's really not like that at all. But there are certain things that you can take out, like certain walls and whatnot. It's pretty fun how they set it up. It's balanced very well, in my opinion, and overall the game runs very smoothly. There was little to no bugs that I experienced at all, even though it is a beta. Now, there are certain things like animations I think that should be cleaned up a little bit more, and some of the player models look a little bit off. I don't know. Maybe it's just how they're going to look on this particular engine, but the game does look beautiful. The maps look beautiful. The way the smoke billows out from tank carcasses and whatnot that you've taken out throughout the match, and it kind of builds up. It feels like a true battle is going on. I really enjoyed it. I enjoyed the atmosphere of it, how there's this all-out war kind of feeling. It's just a very fun game, and I've been finding myself going back to it over and over again because Battlefield won't fix their servers. But this game is genuinely fun. I highly recommend picking it up. It is only available on PC and the next gen console. So if you have one of those platforms, it's free. Just download it, pick it up, and have a good time. Now, speaking of being free and being from the makers of War Thunder, this game does have an extensive progression system. It's not like you're going to find in a Call of Duty or a Battlefield where you just quickly unlock weapons. There are different levels to weapons that you're going to have to unlock, and there's only a few weapons that you're going to have at the start, as well as perks for each soldier within a squad that you have to progress them to be able to unlock these new perks and make them better soldiers. That being said, there's also different ranks to soldiers, so as those soldiers progress, they can equip more perks. You can also upgrade the squad to be able to upgrade the squad's perks as a whole. There's a lot of different things that you can go in and progress, and it's very cool, but it takes a long time to really get anywhere with it. Now, I never found myself really struggling to be able to compete within the game without buying any kind of unlocks. I did get a few like nice guns, like the MP34, or like the grease gun, those kind of automatic weapons, or even sniper rifles. They can be very powerful in this game because a lot of people are only going to be starting out with bolt actions. So once I got those unlocked, I've been finding that those squad members are some of the more powerful ones, but even then the bolt actions are powerful enough on their own. As long as you can land one to two shots, then you're going to be able to get a decent amount of kills. But I've seen a lot of people saying that they're worrying about the game being pay to win. There is a little bit of a catch to it, and I'm not defending the practice, but I'm also not saying that this is 100% a good thing. You can essentially pay for all of the upgraded, all the high-end gear. You can buy it, but you have to level up to actually be able to use it. So there is a bit of a level cap to that, but it is kind of pay to win in that aspect, to where you can essentially just buy the really nice gear, the really nice weapons. So it's kind of hit and miss in that aspect. I know some people are going to have a problem with that. Personally, I found myself still able to compete pretty well just using the base weapons and the base squad members. Now, was that because there weren't any ultra high-end soldiers on the map with me? Could have been that. But regardless, the game is great fun even with the base weapons. You can pick up weapons off of other soldiers as well. So even if you're using one of the more generic soldiers in your squad, you can pick up an MP34 or a grease gun off of a dead enemy and use that against the other team. So you have that kind of aspect to it. There's also two different fronts, and each front is going to have their own couple of squads that you can upgrade. So of course there is the Western Front, which is going to have like D-Day and, you know, the Battle for France and whatnot, and that's going to have the Germans and the Americans. And then the Battle for Moscow, which is the Eastern Front, you're going to have the Russians and the Germans. And there's two separate German factions there. So you're not going to upgrade the Germans on one side and the same progression fall over to the other campaign. They are separate, which is a kind of another hardcore aspect of it, because it's treating it like they're two separate people on two separate areas of the war, which is pretty nice. That's another thing. The hardcore elements, weapons are locked to certain factions. Now, you can pick up cross-faction weapons in the battle, but you can't jump in as an American with an MG42. You just can't do that. There's a lot to this game, as you can tell, I'm sure, but it is great fun. Highly recommend it. Enlist now. check it out in the store for Xbox or PlayStation, whatever you're on, if you have a next-gen console, or you can launch it straight from the Unlisted website if you're on PC. So check that out. I hope you guys enjoy it. If you've already played it, let me know in the description what you think of the game. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Anyway, thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, remember to leave it a nice, thick, and juicy like, and I'll see you in the next video.